Today I will give you information on how to use diagnostic kits in a clinical laboratory. Do you know that nowadays diagnostic kits are used in every section of a clinical laboratory, such as biochemistry, microbiology, immunology, serology, clinical pathology, etc., etc. And I am aware about the problems you face during your training as well as during internship, because these diagnostic kits are quite expensive, and that's why you don't get chance to use these during your training as well as during your internship. And that's why I have decided to give you information on use of diagnostic kits. Look at the diagnostic kit box, you will understand the intended use. For example, in this case, this particular kit is used for urea determination, and 50 tests are possible by using this particular kit. Next thing, you have to find out from the box label the expiry date. If the expiry date is over, then you should not use this diagnostic kit at all. Now open the kit and take out the pamphlet which is placed inside the box, because this pamphlet gives information about system parameters including standard operation procedures, that means how to use the kit as well as how to perform the test. The kit insert, that means the pamphlet of this particular product, will give you following information. First, the name of the test. Now in this case we will take example of urea determination. Clinical significance, that means in which diseases urea will increase and in which diseases urea will decrease. Then what type of specimen you are supposed to use for the test. Then the reference range, that means normal range for male and female, and also according to a specific age group. The kit literature also will give you information about various type of glassware required for the test. Then reconstitution of the reagents and storage after reconstitution of the reagents, because many reagents they supply in the powder form, and then by adding distilled water or reagent grade water, then you reconstitute these reagents, and after reconstitution at what temperature this reagent should be stored, all that information is given. And also about the stability of the reagents, that means at 0 to 4 degrees or 2 to 8 degrees or at room temperature, how long the reagents will be stable. And next is the test procedure. Kit literature will also give you the information on test procedure, that means SOP, standard operation procedure, very important. And then how to calculate test results, then sources of error, that means if the sample is hemolyzed or if bilirubin concentration is high in the sample, what will happen. And also procedure limitations, that means if you get very high values, then the kit will indicate at what stage you are supposed to dilute the sample and repeat the test. Also regarding quality control measures, and if any additional information is there, that is also given by the kit literature. Let us take another example of plasma glucose determination, and the kit literature will give system parameters like this: reaction type, endpoint reaction method, wavelength, flow cell temperature, reagent volume, sample volume, incubation temperature, incubation time, standard concentration, and how to set your photometer or the analyzer for zero setting. And this is with reagent blank. First, find out test requirements from the kit literature, and for glucose determination, these are the requirements: test tube stand, dispenser to dispense reagent, mixer to mix the reagent and specimen, standard or blank, incubator for 37 degrees temperature, then for readings either a photometer or semi-auto analyzer. Now let us see how to use glucose kit for plasma glucose determination. First, you prepare glucose reagent by adding specified volume of distilled water or deionized water, and mix. Your reagent is now ready to use. Then find out how many tests are there. For example, if total number of tests are 8, then set up 8 test tubes, one for standard and one for blank. So total 10 test tubes you have to put up. Then according to standard operation procedure, add 1 ml of glucose reagent in all the 10 tubes. And then add 10 microliter of plasma in the tube from 1 to 8, and in the standard 10 microliter of glucose standard, and in the blank 10 microliter of distilled water. Then incubate these tubes in the water bath set at 37 degrees centigrade. At the end of the incubation time, then you will get various colors formed in the various tubes, and then you have to take readings on the photometer or semi-auto analyzer. And a very important precaution: after finishing the test, store reagents as specified in the kit pamphlet. That means some reagents at 0 to 4 degrees centigrade in the refrigerator, some at 2 to 8 degree centigrade, and some may be at room temperature. For more information, refer to page 39 of chapter 3 of our this book. Thank you. Don't forget to kindly subscribe and share my channel Praful Godkar educational videos on YouTube with your classmates and friends.